commitment to the public and coming around the state on these issues, specifically Commissioner Diane Berman. Please give my regards to the rest of the commissioners as well as the administrative law judge, Ben Wiles. Thank you. I'm Councilmember Ben Kallos. I'm here today on behalf of New York City Public Advocate Letitia James, New York State Senator Brad Coyleman, New York State Assembly Member Walter Mosley, Manhattan Borough President Gail Brewer, and New York City Council Member Ruben Wills. We stand together on behalf of 8.4 million people in the city of New York in hopes that this merger can provide access to free and affordable broadband. Over the past year, the Public Service Commission reviewed a proposed merger between Comcast and Time Warner to determine whether it was in the public interest. During that period, we advocated on behalf of the city of New York seeking preservation of network neutrality, expansion of lifeline eligibility to broadband, and other requests aimed at bridging the digital divide, while expressing overall concerns of anti-competitive elements of the proposed merger. Many initially thought the merger would not be stopped, and if it was stopped, that we would never get another bite at universal broadband. And following that whole situation, we made a lot of progress. The FCC adopted net neutrality. Chairman Wheeler has come out in favor of lifeline eligibility for broadband. On a local level, our mayor has announced the Link NYC, which would provide a free gigabit wireless internet using old pay phones throughout the city. And it turns out our concerns regarding the anti-competitive nature of the other deal were also shared by the Department of Justice, and as a result, Comcast ceased their merger. And now, with new charter, we have another opportunity. In order to just summarize our 3 pages of testimony, what we're looking for from the Public Service Commission, as you do the public interest review, is the following. First, providing low-income New Yorkers with Connect to Compete, a low-cost $9.95 a month broadband, as well as computers, laptops, tablets for $250 or less, along with opening up the 700,000 free public Wi-Fi spots and free training. And I just want to note that I'm very glad that Charter has extended Connect to Compete from Brightline, which they're acquiring, into the Time Warner cable service area, and our hope is to expand that from the free and reduced lunch recipients that would be covered by Connect to Compete to all low-income New Yorkers. We'd also like to see a maintenance and improving the $14.99 per month everyday low price with at least 5 megabits for all New Yorkers, regardless of income, and expansion for small businesses. We'd also like to see the $9.25 per month lifeline discount to low-income phone customers, coupled with Connect to Compete and a commitment to provide provide lifeline discount for broadband with the FCC rollout. Additionally, we'd like to see free broadband for New York City Housing Authority and community centers, as well as free Wi-Fi in all city parks, libraries, and spanning the 700,000 public hotspots that Charter has committed to putting in. And last but not least, investing in New York by bringing jobs, upgrading infrastructure, supporting New York One and public access, which are two of our borough president's favorite items, as well as improving customer service and protecting consumers. Finally, achieving universal broadband is the responsibility of the government that regulates and provides exclusive franchises to cable companies, who must in turn provide free and low-cost broadband, computers, and training to low-income New Yorkers, so we may bridge the digital divide. We've got a second bite at bridging the digital divide in the Big Apple. Thank you.